This is a very unique body of water. They call this lake a one-of-a-kind lake. The lake itself, acreage-wise, is about 9,000 acres of water. It's 3 miles wide by about 5 miles in length. We are what's called the largest Carolina Bay lake. And hence, bay means when people think of bay, they think like a coastal estuary or a coastal body of water. It actually gets its name from bay trees that grow in and around a lake. We have Loblolly Bay, Sweet Bay, and Red Bay. And that's where it gets its name, Carolina Bay. There are four creeks that feed into Lake Waccamaw. All of those are filled with what's called tannic acid that comes from the peat soils that comes in. So if you were to take a clear glass and put into Lake Waccamaw, it would look like you have a glass of tea. That dark tannic color comes from those tannic soils that flow into the creek. Lake Waccamaw State Park has a wide range of activities here for folks to do when they come in. Our visitors love our hiking trails. Coming out here to view wildlife. We have two boardwalks, scenic boardwalks out here. Swimming is allowed in the lake. It's basically you can access the lake at any point on the state park if you wish to go into water. A camper can go, we have a couple of water sites, they can access the lake right through their campsite or through our lakeshore trail here. You can access at any point through the state park into the water if you choose to do that. There are different origins or theories on how the lake formed. One of the most popular is meteorite theory. We also have what's called the sinkhole theory. We have a swimming fish theory. And the one they kind of give the most credence to these days is called wind and wave theory. The wind and wave action theory basically says millions of years ago, when the waters receded to the coast, where we know the ocean is now, it left large pools of water that were out here. And the dominant wind pattern from the north and northeast that came here made elliptical eddies, basically, that carved out these oval shapes. There are several theories out there, of course. So that's the four biggest theories here for Lake Waccamaw. One of my future concerns here as superintendent is the protection of these waters. We did have a scare back in 2012. We had an invasive plant called hydrilla that came in. If we had left that untreated, we were looking at about 95% coverage of hydrilla within a very short period of time, within about 5 or 6 years. My worry is not so much of eradicating hydrilla, because I feel that we have really got a good handle on the hydrilla in the lake. How do we keep other invasives coming in? So the future of this lake is going to depend a lot on the education to the public, to make sure that people properly sanitize and clean their boats when they put on the waters of Lake Waccamaw, and also when they take off, because they don't want to take anything out of the lake that could be infected to another water body or a natural water source in and around North Carolina. It's a peaceful place. People just enjoy the peacefulness, the serenity of coming out here, just enjoying the wildlife viewing opportunities, enjoying a nice, you know, quiet day on the trails, picnicking, camping. We hope to continue those opportunities for many more to enjoy.
Lake Waccamaw State Park is at 1866 State Park Drive in Lake Waccamaw. And like all of our state parks, they're open every day except Christmas. For more information, give the park a call at 910-646-4748 or go to ncparks.gov.